Hello and welcome to the second addendum episode, my 470 playthrough. While browsing through Cold Storage on my hard drive recently, I came to the realization that I never made this mod available to the public before. And given that my approach to some of the aspects appears rather unique among mainstream 1.13 mods, as far as I can figure at least, for instance, enemy item progression, as well as the loadouts of all characters you're going to encounter in the game. Well, I thought to myself, why don't I just put some download links there in the video description along with a convenience package containing all the files necessary to make 470 work. And in case you've been watching this let's play from start to finish or somewhere in between, it may have piqued your interest, giving you an incentive to try it out for yourself. Well, and now you can. And to help you out just a little bit, I can also walk you through the installation process, which doesn't really differ from any other 1.13 mod. And as usual, you start with a clean installation of Vanilla Jaguarlands 2, probably the gold version. Then you take the two self-extracting archives there containing 470, letting it overwrite files when prompted. And afterwards, you just take a 7-zip or some other extractor there and override everything as required, yeah, with the files contained in my mod archive. And that should be all you need, yeah, for at least for the initial setup. But you do have to keep in mind that I designed this mod for my own sake up and foremost, and was either unable or unwilling to compile a fully comprehensive version, if you will. And there are some options you will have to do without, I'm afraid. Most notably the old chance to hit system, as well as the sci-fi mode. Before we get started on this, I do think I can showcase the recommended settings more easily by just starting a new campaign here. And well, experience level, well, to be honest, I designed this with experience in mind, but it doesn't really matter what you choose here. It just increases the number of enemies overall and elites proportionally, making your life all the harder. But I did not adjust any of the additional forces here, if memory serves, so that should not matter, to be honest. It's just up to your personal taste. But you should play with new skill system enabled, which is actually a requirement. The same goes for the realistic mode. I completely ignored sci-fi, and chances are there are at least a couple of aspects broken there, so please do not enable this. But yeah, number of terrorists as well as weapon caches is does not really matter, and the same goes for Bobby Race selection. This is just a quality of life improvement here for the player's sake, so you can select according to your wishes. But I do strongly recommend to go with very low item progression here, as well as keeping enemy double items off. Both of these options combined will ensure that the early game will be a little more enjoyable, I assure you. So that's my recommendation. And you do have to play with new inventory as well as new attachment system enabled. And this also applies to the action point system, which by default should be 100 yeah, action points, the new version, giving you way more flexibility than what the original game shipped with, which was of course 25 action points. And I do think it's default, so you don't have to mess with that at all. And in case you do want to change it for some reason, well, let me tell you that 25 is very quaint, so please don't manually go there to the .ini setting to flip that switch around. It's not worth it. And yeah, tons of guns. Well, reduced I don't think would give you anything, because I did I did not implement an excessive number of additional firearms and all the other types of material to go along with them. That is ammunition and hand grenades or armor types. So I do think even if you choose tons of guns, it should not present you with an overwhelming and overlapping and redundant number of weapons. So I do think tons of guns would be the way to go, and that's all we need for now for the game settings. But as I've mentioned, unfortunately I did not playtest with the old chance to hit system. I mean, I did not break backwards compatibility like entirely. In theory it should work, but when putting in the values there and the various XML files, I went, you know, by theoretical balance only. It's not playtested whatsoever. in comparison to Nugent's Dread, and wow, I spent way more time than I was comfortable with, to be honest, to tweak the Nugent's Dread system to its maximum potential, I should say. Even given the rather limited feature set we had to work with here in 470. But I do think you will find the experience way more enjoyable compared to the default values 470 shipped with. But there was only so much that could be done. For instance, a newer version, like my Urban Chaos campaign, they give you way more flexibility and tweakability when it comes to Nugent's Dread. But I do think the best possible balance here has been achieved, at least to my liking. And I do hope you will agree with me there. And I do think that's all we need for the options right now. What about major bugs here? Well, the only one I can think of right now would relate to the items placed in the map editor, because there was a little history rundown here, if you will. Well, the map editor was originally bundled with the Unfinished Business standalone expansion pack of Jacklands 2, and for some reason they went with the design decision to actually take some of the item properties as they were at the time and then hard code them into the map files, if you will. So that means that some of the properties will remain static regardless of what you set in the XML files. I mean, certain parameters such as caliber, damage, and vehicle, and so on and so forth. Well, all of this is update dynamically and automatically, which is all good and well. But as far as attachment goes, well, there's no way to update those except to delete those items and then we see them. Well, but the problem with the map editor is it's relative unstableness, and if you apply mods on top of the game, well, it becomes even more quirky and glitchy and buggy than usual, and I just could not be bothered, I'm sorry. So you will continue to run into weapons missing default attachments, one at least, or even up to three. For instance, folding stock and an integral foregrip and some sort of master device. The only advice I can give you is to just ignore those weapons or sell them at Tony's, because while they will still fetch the full price. And you just pick up whatever you can get from the ground, and well, it's not a massive problem overall, to be honest, except for those stockpile sectors, for instance, the army depot or one of the random weapon caches. But it's more of a minor inconvenience, if nothing else. And well, another piece of advice I can give you, well, 470 or the 1.3 mod in general, if you do want to play in Winup mode, you have to navigate to the executable and then to the compatibility options and enable 16-bit color dev. Otherwise, it's not possible to play in Windows mode, unless, well, I don't, actually, it just occurred to me that in Windows 10 you cannot even set your desktop to anything less than 32 color dev anymore, can you? Okay, and what else? I don't think there is anything else to talk about. That should be the initial setup here. And well, everything else should be fully functional. And I invested a great deal of time as well as thought overall to make sure that the entire mod is balanced properly. And I do think, and I hope for that matter, that you should find it to your liking. There should, as I've mentioned, there should not be an excessive number of additional items in the game, and everything else, well, firearms, ammo types, ABE gear, camouflage, everything should be well-rounded, because I would not have accepted anything less, to be honest. I'm a little bit of an perfectionist, for that matter. And well, in case you do give it a try, maybe leave a comment on this video or something and tell me how you liked it, or what you didn't like for that matter. So, I do think that's all finally, and once again, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you for the next playthrough, whatever that may be.